Well, joining us is the latest Dundee Stars signing. It's Kyle Pouncey. Kyle, firstly, I've got to ask you, how delighted are you to be a Dundee Star for this upcoming season?
Well, I mean, honestly, it hasn't sunk in, I think, fully, but I'm super excited to get to Dundee. I've heard nothing but good things from guys that have played on the team in the past, guys that are signed right now, that they're excited. And yeah, no, it's super exciting right now. It's hard to contain it, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, this deal was put together rather quickly, but has it been a summer of real contemplation, a summer of thinking about what that next step was going to be?
Yeah, you know, honestly, like, this is obviously a pretty late choice by me, and I was fully set on going back to Utah and the East Coast Hockey League, where I've been there for the past 2 years. So honestly, I signed there pretty early again, and that was the plan. And this opportunity kind of came up this past week, and talked to my agent, family, and it was just ultimately a choice that I couldn't say no to. And it was a real tough decision, for sure. Really liked where I was in Utah, and loved every part of that experience and everything there. But just the opportunity to go overseas has always been a dream of mine. And when this opportunity came up, like I said, it was too hard to pass up.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. You know, 2 seasons in Utah, and I know you were announced as signing back. And I suppose one of the biggest compliments you can always get when signing back is fans delight to see that. And looking through their social media posts at the time when you'd announced you'd be back, it seemed like the fans were ecstatic. I mean, it must have been a tough choice in one way after spending 2 great seasons there.
100%. And I think that was the major hurdle of it all, was just, you know, I really did feel like I, you know, put some roots down in Utah. Felt kind of a second home to me. Just a ton of connections, a ton of great people there. So just a lot of memories. And it was definitely a hard hurdle for me to get over to accept that I was going to be leaving there. And yeah, it was just a moment and kind of just a crossroads in life. And just felt like I said, this was something that was always on my radar, and it felt like this was maybe the right time to do it. So sometimes you got to leave a good thing behind for something else. And that's definitely kind of one of those cases, I think.
So how far ago did those conversations with Mark Lefebvre start then? And what was the discussions that made you think, actually, I'm going to give it a try in Europe. I'm going to give it a try in the United Kingdom and at Dundee Stars.
Well, Mark seemed like a great guy right off the start, very personable, kind of gave me the down low on everything. And just talking to other guys, I think, about the experience. Like I said, this league in general has, you know, got a great reputation. It seems like it's kind of trending even to a, you know, higher direction. And so it didn't take a crazy amount of convincing in that aspect. You know, I was really excited about the prospect of it. And like I said, coming back to it, it was more of just leaving what I had before was definitely the biggest challenge, because everything in Dundee seemed like a really good opportunity and chance. And, you know, just to see the world over there, guys I know are there, you know, everything kind of seemed to align in that aspect. And that's kind of all came together. Mark seemed like a great guy, and he was building a really good team from what I saw. And, you know, I'm excited to be a part of it.
And you really properly started that pro career through tough times, actually. It was in the COVID kind of seasons. How difficult was that to really launch yourself after, of course, your college days?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that's a crazy long story. It was tough for everyone. So many buddies that were in it together kind of with me. And I mean, I'm sure you've heard stories from other guys. Almost everyone was affected in a certain way. Like for me, I was right out of college. I got my first chance in pro in Wichita, and it was super exciting. Got a few games in there, and that's when COVID hit and shut us down mid-season. And I had to go basically straight home, leave all my belongings, or leave most of my belongings at school. Some of them are still there, honestly, and then kind of reset. And luckily, I kind of got the chance to go back to Wichita for the start of the COVID season, but it was just too hard, too good of a league to stick around that year with the limited teams and all those kind of factors that just kind of pushed me out of a spot and led me kind of down a crazy scenic route, obviously, from I'm sure you've seen. And it's a long story, but yeah, I mean, lots of challenges, like everyone has their own kind of story in that. And honestly, like, built a bunch of good connections and memories, good, bad, and ugly, throughout that whole process that I wouldn't change.
Was there any ever any temptation, like some players, to make that jump to Europe then, you know, where there was some leagues still to play in, or was it a focus of, kind of, I'll stay at home and I suppose be cautious of everything that was going around?
Yeah, I guess I trying to recall back, and I had the opportunity to go back to Wichita at the start of that next year. And that was kind of my full focus, is trying to make the most of that opportunity. And obviously it just didn't work out at the time. And at that point, it was so hard to find another job anywhere else, Europe, North America, and beyond there. So it was kind of just, you know, you're rolling with the punches at that point. You know, you had all your chips in one basket because you had no other choice. And then you just kind of adapted from there. So led me down a wild road. But yeah.
It sure did. Was there a worry at that point that you might not play professional hockey, or was the focus always, I'm going to keep fit, I'm going to train in any way I can to be ready when the opportunity came?
For sure. And that's just it. As you know, I was like, I can't let this be the deciding factor for me playing pro or not, right? It felt a little out of my control at the time, but the only thing I could control was, just like you said, continuing to train and get better. During that time, when after I got released from Wichita, I actually got to go be helping as assistant coach at my old college in the Wisconsin there. And through that whole time, I was staying ready, skating with the team, skating on my own time, training, just hoping I'd get an opportunity to play. And, you know, the opportunity that arose wasn't exactly the one that was high up on my list. But, you know, at that point, I was training so much. It was a chance to play. I got to go to the team in Carolina there for a couple weeks, and then I got to call up to Knoxville to finish the year for a month there. And it was a wild journey, but like I said, I feel like I built a lot of connections throughout that process and learned a lot about myself and the game, and it all ended up working out in its own way.
And I suppose now at this point, you know, you'll thank those folks who gave you such an opportunity at that time, because there was nothing really, I mean, yeah. If it wasn't for those guys, you know, you might be struggling right now to be where you are, I suppose.
For sure. Yeah, no, I mean, it was all part of the process of, you know, hoping you get a chance. And that's when you kind of rely almost on some connections that you built, and you kind of take some chances. And that's kind of what that whole year was. And, you know, it ended up working out. I got to play some hockey, kind of got to explore around in a time where a lot of people couldn't. I know if I went back home to Canada here, it was really locked down at that time, and you couldn't do a whole lot. So I was really fortunate to just be able to stay down in the U.S. and able to do a little bit more than maybe the average folk up here, and still get to play, you know, the game that I wanted to play. And it ultimately led to the opportunity in Utah, and obviously 2 years there that I, you know, two of the best years of my life. So it really all worked itself out. It was there were definitely some doubts throughout the process of what's going to happen and stuff, but it was just kind of sticking through the process and hoping for the best.
And you mentioned that time at Utah. Let's talk about that first season you had there, the 21-22 season. What's it like in your head? You know, you've had that up and down few years beforehand. Was the focus like, I've got to get myself in this team and I want a full consistent season, or what was your aspirations and goals at that point before you even dropped the puck to start that season?
For sure. I think the ultimate goal was to stay there, right? And do anything I can to possibly stay. It was so unknown going in. Everyone was kind of didn't know what to expect, right? There was, you know, the brand new season, all the teams were back. There was a lot of open spots, a lot of opportunity. So I kind of was just trying to make the most of it. I got really fortunate to be in a good situation where, you know, the coaching staff gave me a chance, and, you know, I was around some really good players, had a really good setup, you know, good roommates. I had the same roommate for 2 years. All those little things kind of helped make the process easier. And, you know, it wasn't always easy. There was times where, you know, you always worry at what's going to happen and if you're going to stick around and stuff like that. And I'm just grateful that I was able to stay for two full years there. And I learned so much from the guys I was playing with, and at that level, that caliber, just a lot of good players in the league. And I think I grew a lot as a player and a person, and yeah, super grateful for that.
And we know how cutthroat that league can be. When you hit that second season, is there an extra pressure on you thinking, you know, I've been here a year already? Some people could fall into that settled mode, but I suppose in that league, you can't do that because it is so cutthroat and things can change all the time.
Definitely. And I mean, you have those hard conversations with your coach, and we always talked about how, you know, you can't get comfortable and you just got to keep leveling up if you can. There's always guys that are coming into the league that are, they're hungry and looking to take jobs, and it's a business. And fortunately, you know, the coaches there were really good about trying to keep a tight knit group there for the most part. And as much as they could, kind of keep the same guys and that they enjoyed having. And I'm grateful for that for sure. Cause there was times where I'm sure there was guys knocking on the door for jobs that they could have, you know, took guys, and they stuck with me through some of those times. And yeah, I'm super fortunate for that.
And we normally ask how you feel a coach is going to improve your game, and we can talk about that later. But how did the coaches there at Utah improve your game, Kyle, to where it is at this point, would you say?
I think the biggest thing is consistency at the pro level. The margin for error just, you know, gets smaller and smaller as the level you go up. Just kind of staying within yourself, knowing when to go, when not to go. It's all, like I said, consistency is the biggest thing. Just day in, day out, being a professional. I think just getting those game reps, like I said, with probably a level that I hadn't played at before, right? And getting those repetitions just, I think, automatically makes you a better player, being put in kind of tough spots. You learn a lot about yourself through trial and error. And luckily enough, I was put in some of those positions, and I think you just kind of naturally grow. And I think that's the biggest thing for sure. It's just bringing that consistency day in and day out, and understanding how the game works. I mean, it's a different kind of style. I'm sure, you know, other guys would agree, like you come from college and you play pro, it's an adjustment. So, you know, just little things here and there, how to, you know, way the structure of the game goes, positioning, all that kind of stuff, you know, through the game film, all that kind of stuff. Really helps. And I think I got exposed to that a lot in Utah, and hopefully I can translate it over here in Dundee as well.
And what have some of your teammates that said about the Elite League that they know? And what have former or players that play in the Elite League said to you about the Elite League and what it brings?
Like I said at the start, I think it's just a league that continues to grow. I've heard, you know, nothing but good things about, honestly, all the teams. And just, I think, you know, playing over in a place like that is very enticing for a lot of us guys who have played on a tough schedule in the ECHL, for example, where you're traveling a lot. You know, travel's not as strenuous, all that kind of stuff, a little less games. So, you know, it's appealing in that aspect where you can kind of take care of your body maybe a little bit more. But yeah, like guys that have played, you know, in Dundee specifically have talked about the city and the fans and, you know, all the little things in between that, you know, help an organization go round. So that was huge. You know, you hear it from the coach and then you hear it from other guys. Means a lot. So, yeah.
Are you ready for our big rivalry games, our big derby games against the locals like Fife and Glasgow? Is that the kind of games you get excited for, Kyle?
For sure. Yeah, no, I think like noticing and hearing that, you know, how the league runs there, how every game matters that much more because of the winner of the league is kind of the most important thing from my understanding. So that, I mean, that in itself is huge. There's no kind of throwaway games. You know, sometimes you can get lost in the mix of 72 games. For example, on the East Coast, whereas every game really, truly does matter in the EIHL. So that's super important and super exciting for sure. I mean, every game matters, and it's, you know, you can get up for every game because it's so crucial. And I think the expectations are high and the pressure is on, which is, you know, awesome and a great challenge for all of us.
And it does. It starts really, really full on, you know, right into Challenge Cup action. You know, you've got league action, which of course we're going for those to be as high up in that league as possible, hopefully win it, you know, and as well as that, get as high up in the standings for that playoff series, which is such a quick fire moment at the end of the season. But as I'm sure Mark's told you, it's probably the thing that people remember the most after the season's finished, where, you know, you're just a few games away from a playoff final in front of thousands of people, you know, and an opportunity to really win something.
Absolutely. No, I mean, playoffs is just, it's a different animal, and it's just so exciting to be a part of. I mean, my first year in Utah, we were able to go to the conference finals and we were playing in some crazy, crazy buildings with some wild fans. And just, I mean, I remember taking a step back in those moments and being like, wow, this is pretty cool. And, you know, it's just such a privilege to be in this position. So, if, you know, we can find ourselves in, you know, a position like that. I think it's been a few years since Dundee's been in those positions. So we'd really like to kind of flip the script and get Dundee back on track and in playoffs and personally playing those meaningful hockey games, because there's really nothing that compares.
Absolutely. And I suppose fans will want me to ask you when we can possibly expect you across here. I know there's only a few weeks until the season starts and a few weeks till induction week as well.
Yeah, no, for sure. I think we're a couple weeks away here. Like I said, it was quick. Kind of, it was a last minute choice for me. So it's kind of just figuring out all the house cleaning items, you know, making sure all my stuff's in order to get over there and make sure the body's all ready to go. Been training all summer for this. So it's obviously a quick turnaround, but I feel like I'm ready to go. It's super exciting. It's right around the corner. I hope everyone's excited as much as we are.
I'm sure everyone is. If you've got a final message for the Stars fans, Kyle, what would it be?
Thanks for having me. I'm super excited. Can't wait to kind of, you know, get a chance to show myself and be part of this team. Like I said, lots of good players. I'm joining my buddy Johnny Walker, old teammate. He was definitely one of the reasons why Dundee made a lot of sense. And I know if I'm just speaking on him, the fans will really love him. And I can't wait to kind of be a part of that for sure.
Kyle, what a way to put the final comments into the interview by putting your best buddy over. I mean, you know, he didn't do that for you. To be fair, you weren't signed at the time. You know, he was probably asking you to come. But yeah, what a guy.
Oh, what a guy for sure. Yeah, I know. I think he, you know, obviously coaches do their due diligence and they call around and see how guys are and stuff. And I think I owe a lot to Johnny. He definitely put in a good word for me, I think. And he's quite the character. He's going to be a fan favorite, I imagine. And, you know, he's a guy who's just super passionate. He's going to give you 110 every night, stick up for anybody. And he'll definitely generate a few laughs. There's no doubt about that.
Well, from one fan favorite to another, in yourself, you know, the reference worked out clearly well, Kyle, and everything's all good. And we'll see you in a few short weeks. Before we wrap up, we'll just remind fans that season tickets and tickets for all of our pre-season games are on sale, and you can get more information about that on dundeestars.com. I'm sure you'd like to see everybody there every week, Kyle, and the place packed, bringing the noise while the Stars reach for major success this season.
Absolutely. No, please come out and support us. We're going to be trying our best to give you a good product, no doubt about it.
That's great, Kyle. Take care. Have a safe trip across here. It's literally a few weeks until it all kicks off, and we'll see you very shortly.
You betcha. Thank you so much. Appreciate you having me.